Hi guys, this is Nishita and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a complete Q&A video for all those who are aspiring to come study in Canada. I recently traveled to Canada, in case you guys are not aware, and I'm just in the settling process. I'm still in my 14-day quarantine period. So yeah, I thought I would do like an informative video which might help a lot of you who are planning to come to Canada this year for studies. So I asked you guys to ask me questions on Instagram and I got like a bunch of questions. So because I filmed with my phone, I just wrote down all the important questions, all the repetitive questions in this paper, and I'm gonna answer each and every question in detail for you guys. So without any further delay, let's just get right into the video. The first question that was asked is, which exam did you apply and write for moving to Canada as a student? Now, I wrote IELTS exam. And that was the only exam that I had to take in order to get my admission here in a college. Is IELTS enough or do we also need a GRE score? Now, it totally depends on the university or the college that you're applying to. My college just required the IELTS score, and I think most of the colleges here in Canada and the universities here in Canada accept just the IELTS score. But having said that, there are a few colleges that accept GRE score as well. So make sure you're well aware before applying to your college. Did you take any coaching for IELTS? Now, no, I did not take any external coaching for IELTS, but I had this book that I used to practice every single day, and I think I practiced for solid, like, you know, 15 to 20 days. I used to do like a practice test every single day, and yeah, that was basically my preparation for IELTS. And the next question is, what was your IELTS score and which consultancy did you approach for your admissions? So my IELTS score, I think the overall band that I got was 7.5, and I think I did really good because I literally like prepared only for 15 days and then I just gave my exam, and I was really proud when I got my result. And the consultancy that I approached was IDP. Now, hands down, the best consultancy. They were really, really supportive. They helped me in every single process, right from my admission and application to college to visa. They took care of literally everything. So yeah, in case you guys are looking for a good consultancy in order to travel to Canada like for studies, I would highly, highly recommend IDP. The next question is, how did you choose your college? And is it safe for Indians to study there, and any difficulties you faced? All right, let me go one by one. How did I choose my college? Now, before I get into more details, let me first tell you what exactly am I studying. I am studying Information Systems Business Analysis. It's a one-year PGDM course. Now, I just knew that I wanted to study business analysis. Like right at the go, I just knew that if I would do any further education, I wanted it to be in the field of business analysis. So yeah, it was really easy for me to choose my college because not a lot of colleges offer this course. So when I did my research, I stumbled upon George Brown College, and then I really liked their courses included in this program, and right at the go I was like, this is what I want to do. So if I had to give you like some tips on choosing your college, the first thing you have to do is, in your mind, you should know what you want to study, like what would you see yourself doing for the rest of your life, you know, be it a career choice, because it's not really easy to study abroad, like because it involves like a lot of money. So make sure you are choosing a course that is worth investing in. The next question was, is it safe for Indians to study there? According to me, Canada is one of the most safest places. But having said that, you have to know your limits. You have to know what exactly you're doing, and you got to be smart enough. Yeah, that's how I think you would survive here in Canada or anywhere else for that matter of concern. And any difficulties you face. So this is literally my day seven in Canada. Yeah, and so far everything's perfect. My landlord's been really, really sweet to me. I have like my best friend here, so yeah, so far so good. Do Canadian universities give scholarship to Indians? Yes, a lot of colleges and universities do offer scholarship for international students, but to make sure and to get more details about it, I would suggest you to go through the college or the university website, and yeah, you would get like a lot of details right on the website. The next question, okay, lots of questions regarding fees. Now guys, it totally varies from college to college, university to university, the course you're taking, the location of your institution, etc., etc. So I would not really be able to give you guys like the exact figure. So yeah, I would suggest you again to go through the college website, because that'll have like the figures mentioned, and then you know you can calculate it out for yourself. How did you start the visa process? Now, like I mentioned earlier, IDP has been super helpful in like every stage of my you know, admission process and visa process. So let me start off with how this entire thing started. So the first thing that I did was consult an agent at IDP. So they will give you like, you know, course options, college options, etc., and then you just have to choose and apply. So fun story, I just applied to literally one college and luckily I got in. So grateful. So I just applied to GBC and I got in. So yeah, like you can first, you know, start off with choosing your college and you know, start your admission, like give your fill in your application form and stuff like that, and IDP would help you with that. The next thing you'll have to do is wait for your you know, acceptance letter from college, and once you have that, you can start your visa application process. So there are basically two forms that you have to fill. This might be very vague, so yeah, everything, like every step, IDP will take care of it, you guys. So yeah, that's what happened in my case as well. Next question. I am a CSE student. Tell me some courses in Canada that does not require coding. Girl, I feel you. I am in the same boat. Even though I am a CSE student, I'm not really fond of coding. I feel like my skill set is entirely different. So yeah, like there is cyber security, there's business analysis, like the course that I'm currently doing. There are a lot of business management courses like HR management, project management, etc. So yeah, you have like a lot of choices if you don't really like coding. All right, so basically these were all the questions that I got regarding my admission process, college, etc. Now the next set of questions are regarding my travel. Now the first question is, are there direct flights from India to Canada? Was it a direct flight from Hyderabad to Canada? Okay, so now Canada has imposed a flight ban for direct flights from India to Canada given the rise in COVID-19 cases. So what I did was I traveled via a third country, and that is totally legal. So the Canadian government is not ready to accept any RT-PCR tests from India, but if you are an Indian passport holder, then they would definitely accept, you know, your RT-PCR test that was taken in a third country. And that is exactly what I did. So first I had my flight from Hyderabad to Ethiopia. Now Hyderabad to Ethiopia, the journey was broken down into two parts. I had to first travel to Doha, and then I had like a long layover there, and then my next flight was from Doha to Ethiopia. And in Ethiopia, I had to stay back because I had to give my COVID test. And yeah, once I got my result, I was ready to go. Then I had my flight from Ethiopia to Canada via Dublin. So there was just like a 1 hour stop at Dublin for fueling. We didn't really have to get off the plane. So yeah, this was my journey. Next question. Do we need to submit vaccine certificate or just COVID test report is enough to travel? So guys, when I was traveling, I was not asked any vaccine certificate. I had to just produce my COVID test result. Yeah, that's about it. How was your hotel quarantine experience? Did you pre-book your hotel? Okay, so for those of you who don't know, after you get into Canada, you'll have to quarantine in a government approved hotel for 3 days. But as soon as you arrive into Canada, you have to give a COVID test at the airport. And once that result is out, then you are free to go out of the hotel but to quarantine again for 11 days in a private room which has a private washroom and where you don't come in contact with anyone else. So basically it's a 14 day long quarantine period. And as per the question, how was your hotel quarantine experience? Trust me, it was amazing. So we were staying at Crown Plaza and I thought it was really, really good. Did you pre-book your hotel? Yes, I did pre-book my hotel. I'm a big time planner, so yeah, I had to pre-book my hotel. But I think there's also an option to book it after you arrive at the airport, but yeah, I thought it would be much safer if I had booked earlier. The next question, is the 11 day quarantine in hotel not in effect now? Can we go home after 3 day hotel quarantine? No, like I mentioned earlier, it's a 14 day long quarantine period. The first 3 days you stay in a government approved hotel and the next 11 days you have to isolate yourself in a private room with a private washroom where you have no contact with the outside world whatsoever. How to find accommodation if we don't have company? Alright guys, so what I did was I went on to Kijiji.com and I searched for like a lot of rentals and I you know used to contact the landlords and talk to them about, you know, how it is, what it is, and like get to know a lot about the property. And then I would like shortlist a few of them and then I would revise that list again. So that's how I found my place and I'm really happy with it. So yeah, all I would say is do your research. Kijiji is great. There's also a Facebook marketplace, but I don't think we can access like the Canadian rooms or the Canadian rentals in India. But Kijiji is something that you can access from India. And yeah, like if you don't have company, okay, that's quite a tricky question. Because I had my friend here, she would like go for a viewing and you know, she would let me know how it is, what she thinks of it, and then we would discuss and then finalize. But if you don't have company, I mean, if you're going for like, let's say study purpose or something, you would have friends, right? So maybe you can get along with them and look for something. Do we have to find a place to live before we move? Yeah, so like I mentioned earlier, I am a big time planner and I do not like doing things in the last moment. So yeah, what I did was I booked my hotel, booked my you know, stay, everything before I arrived to Canada. But it's totally a personal choice. Next question is room tour. Yes guys, I would definitely do a room tour. My room is so, so pretty and I cannot wait to share it with you guys. I just decorated this wall. I think you would have already seen that in a vlog, or if not, then you will see it in the coming vlog. So yeah, I think I would do like a room tour really, really soon, maybe by the mid of next month. The next question, Canada versus USA, what would you suggest? Now, honestly speaking, I did not really do any comparison of that sort because I just knew what program I wanted to take, what courses I wanted to study. So yeah, like it totally depends. It's a personal choice, you guys. I don't know how to answer this, but I would just leave it at it's a personal choice. Please let me know what are the major things to carry from India to Canada while packing. Okay, so I carry like 3 big suitcases and most of the stuff were like I just carried food, like comfort food, you know, because I'm traveling away from home for like the first time. So I wanted to make sure that I have everything like in terms of food available that wouldn't make me miss home so much. So apart from that, I also had some clothes, but I would suggest you guys not to carry like a lot of clothes. So apart from that, what else did I carry? I had like a lot of skincare because that is where my work revolves around, right? So yeah, I had to carry my work stuff like products and yeah, stuff like that. But yeah, I would suggest you to carry like a lot of food, like comfort food, like I mentioned. And if you are coming in winter, then get some like basic, you know, winter clothes. But if you're coming in summer, then yeah, like just get some summer clothes and also include like a jacket or two. what I was suggested is to buy like the winter stuff here in Canada, because the quality and all is different here, right? So whatever is made here suits the climate. So that is exactly what I did. I did not like dump in like a lot of winter wear, because I am planning to go shopping like right after my quarantine ends, so that, because now it's summer, right? So everything is on sale. So now is the perfect time to shop winter wear. The next question. Why didn't you directly go for PR? Now, this is quite an interesting question. It is because I wanted to study. So, I've been working in the IT field for almost like 4 years, and I wanted to take a break. I wanted to learn something and then master it, and then, you know, get into the same field. But to cut things short, I wanted to pursue a program which will help me get into the exact same job that I desire. Like I mentioned, business analysis, and I desire and I'm passionate about being a business analyst. And I think with that, we are done with all the questions. I hope this video was helpful, you guys. If you have more questions, let me know in the comment section below. And also, if I have done any mistakes or anything of that sort, please excuse me, because I am not a pro. I am still learning about things. On that note, I'm going to end the video right here. I hope you guys found this informative. If you have any more questions, please let me know in the comment section below. Or you could also DM me on my Instagram. Make sure you're following me there as well. And subscribe to my channel, because a lot of fun Canadian vlogs are coming up super, super soon. I will see you in my next one. Until then, bye.